Hi everyone. In this video, what I want to show you how to do is how you can do data validation. One of the problems that you can run into with spreadsheets is sometimes data entry errors. So if there's a way to do data validation, then you should encourage your staff to do so, especially in protecting financial data. So let me show you how this works. I've already created one where I have this field where I can enter the month of the year. And you'll see the little drop-down arrow right there. And if I click on that, it will give me the months of the year to choose in the format that I want them to be in. What I've done in order to create that is I have a data validation tab, and here are the months. Now, I'm gonna go back to my input tab, and you'll notice that I have a category right here, but I haven't set the data validation. I want to show you how I've done that. So you go over to the data tab and click on data validation. Now you need to be on the cell that you want this to be inserted in, and I have already done that. And then I have this dialog box that comes up. And what I want it to do is to validate against a list. Now you have some other options here, and Excel is really good with help. So if you want to find out how to do others in here, you can certainly use the help functions in Excel, which is the F1 key, to find out more about this. I'm going to use a list. So I click on that, and then I need to go to the source. So I'll click on this little icon right over here, and I will go back to my data validation tab. And this is going to be my range of values that I'm going to use for categories. I click this little icon again, and now you see that it's looking at that data validation tab in that range of cells for the values. And I click OK. Now, when I click on the category, it has this nice drop-down list that is based on that list that I put in my data validation tab. Now the nice thing about data validation, and any tab, frankly, within Excel, is that if I right click on data validation, I could hide this tab so people don't even necessarily know that it's there. I can password protect that tab. I can do all kinds of things to protect the data in it. And if I want to modify it, all I have to do is right click on any tab, unhide, and you will see that I can unhide that tab. So this way, if you do data validation, you are able to put in the values that you want so that someone who's doing data entry doesn't make any errors or mistakes in the data itself, and that can help cut down on errors and ensure data integrity. If you have any questions, please leave them below. Be happy to help, and I look forward to seeing you on another video. Thank you.